Yes, another integration question from Putnam competition. Exciting. We want to evaluate double integral, and we are going from x equals to 0 to a, and y equals to 0 to b, and we have e raised to the maximum value of b squared x squared or a squared y squared. So if b squared x squared is greater than a squared y squared, we are going to raise e to b squared x squared. And when we have values x and y, such that a squared y squared is greater than b squared x squared, then we're going to raise e to a squared y squared. And we have a and b being positive. Okay, I'm not quite sure how to start this because of this maximum function. So let's think about how b squared x squared and a squared y squared compare in size in the region we are integrating over. So in our case, we are integrating over x from 0 to a and y from 0 to b. I'm not sure if relative sizes of a and b matter just yet. So let's leave it as a greater than b. Maybe we have to consider the case where b is greater than a later on. Hopefully not. But let's draw our region. So we are integrating over this region. And for the values of x and y, so if we take a point x and y, and we evaluate b squared x squared and a squared y squared, how are they going to vary in size? Which one is going to be larger? And if so, in what region, in what values of x and y, inside this rectangle of dimension AB? Let's start by realizing that for the point 0, 0 at the origin, we have b squared x squared being equal to a squared y squared, because for this value x is 0 and y is 0. And I also see something, that when we're looking at this point AB, the right upper corner of this rectangle, we have b squared x squared being equal to a squared y squared once again, because b squared x squared is going to be b squared a squared, and a squared y squared is going to be a squared b squared. X is a and y is b, so they are equal for this point. And maybe I'm taking this way too far, but we have to hope, we have to imagine, maybe for every single point xy on this purple line connecting 0, 0 and ab, b squared x squared is going to be equal to a squared y squared. And it looks like it, because what is the equation of this line? Equation of this line is y is equal to b over ax. So for any point along this line, so for this point, we know the coordinate of this point is going to be x, b over a, x. And if you look at a squared y squared, we get a squared times b over a, x squared. And we are going to get a squared times b squared over a squared x squared. And a squared cancel out. So we get b squared x squared being equal to a squared y squared for any point along this purple line. That's fantastic. So maybe we have to divide. We have to divide this integral to one integral of the upper triangle. So one, we can integrate over this upper triangle, and we can integrate over the lower triangle separately. And then add them up. Maybe that's how we're going to do it. And what do we know about this upper triangle? What is the relative size of b squared x squared and a squared y squared on this upper triangle? Let me label this upper triangle T1 and the lower triangle T2. Just for notation's sake. And on T1, realize for any point on T1, for example this point, we can get this point by starting with this point on the line and moving to the left. So at this point on the purple line, we know b squared x squared is equal to a squared y squared. As we move this point to the left, so as x is decreasing and y is staying the same, we're going into T1, we're going into the upper triangle. So for this point, b squared x squared is going to be smaller than a squared y squared, because our y stayed the same, but our x went down. And the same can be said for any point in T1, for this point, we're starting with this point, where b squared x squared is equal to a squared y squared, and we're simply decreasing x while y stay the same. So for any point on T1, b squared x squared is going to be less than a squared y squared. And similarly, for any point in T2, we can get that point by starting with a point on the purple line where b squared x squared is equal to a squared y squared and increasing the value of x. So for any point in T2, b squared x squared is going to be greater than a squared y squared. So we know this integral is equal to double integral over T1 over the upper triangle of E, and on the upper triangle, a squared y squared is going to be larger than b squared x squared. So we are raising e to a squared y squared dA plus the integral, double integral over T2, and on T2, we know b squared x squared is going to be larger than a squared y squared, and we want to evaluate each of these and add them up. So let's start with the first one. For the first one, let me redraw the rectangle really quickly, so because that's too messy right now. The first diagram is too messy, so let's redraw this. And we know equation of this line is y equals to b over a x. And we know that's a, that's b, and we know we can also write this as x is equal to a over b y. So we know that's the equation of this line, And for T1, how can we evaluate this? So for T1, for the upper triangle, we're going from y equals to 0 to b. So our y is going from 0 to b, while our x value is going from 0 to the line, our x value is going from 0 all the way to a over by. So our x value is going from 0 to this line for the upper triangle, and we have e to the a squared y squared dx dy. And what is this? So that's just for T1. And we will evaluate T2 as well. And we know this is going to be y is going from 0 to b, and integrating this with respect to x is going to get us x times e to the a squared y squared, while x is going from 0 to a over by dy. And of course, this is integral from 0 to b of our x is a over by, e to the a squared y squared, when x is 0, we get 0, and dy, and we can integrate this pretty easily. That's what is this? We have a over b, and we want to have e to the a squared y squared, but we have to divide it by 2a squared, because the derivative of a squared y squared is a squared times 2y, so we want to divide it by 2a squared, so we only have y left. So we know that's how it's going to be. And of course, y is going from 0 to b. And when y is b, we get 1 over 2ab. So 1a's are going to cancel out. And we have e to the a squared b squared minus e to the 0 power or 1. That's the value of our integral for the upper triangle. I want to point something out. If you had set the bounds for the upper triangle such that our x is going from 0 to a, so our x is going from 0 to a, and our y is going from the line b over ax to b of our function a squared y squared dy dx, if this was the way you set up the bounds for the upper triangle, which is valid, the value of this integral and the value of this integral, they are the same. These two are equivalent. But what is wrong with doing it this way? Well, if you do it this way, you gotta integrate e to the a squared y squared with respect to y, and that's not going to be an elementary function, so you cannot integrate this. Whereas, if you set up the bounds like this, where you integrate with respect to x before, that's going to allow you to introduce factor of y inside this integral when you integrate with respect to y. So this is the way to go. So I wanted to point that out. Just because you have two different ways of setting up the integral doesn't mean you should do it either way. Usually there's one way that's more efficient or only one way that actually works using elementary function. So having pointed that out, let's go on to T2. For T2, let's go up just a bit. Our x is going to go from 0 to a. Our x is going from 0 to a. And our y is going to go from 0 to the line, 0 to b over a x. And we have e to the b squared x squared dy dx. And what is the value of this? Well, it's integral from 0 to a. And we have e to the b squared x squared y from y equals to 0 to b over ax dx. And of course, this is integral from 0 to a of e to the b squared x squared times b over ax dx. And using the same reasoning as below, we're going to get e to the b squared x squared, and of course we should have b over a, and using the same reasoning as below, we want to divide by 2bx, 2b squared x, I meant to say, and we are integrating from 0 to a, and this is going to get us 1 over 2ab, and we're going to have e to the a squared b squared minus 1 once again. So, what is our final answer? We want to add up these two. We want to add up 1 over 2ab times e to the a squared b squared minus 1, but we have two of them, so we simply have to multiply one of these by 2. So we are adding up two equivalent things, so we simply have to multiply this by 2, which is going to get us 1 over ab times e to the a squared b squared minus 1, and we are done. And you could have figured it out using the symmetry of t1 and t2 and having a squared y squared b squared x squared and symmetry of a and b, you could have figured out that these two are the same. Anyway, what is our final answer to this question? Well, that's 1 over ab times e to the a squared b squared minus 1.